Fejosbaba Talent Workshop, FTW, a subsidiary of Premium Academy, comes up with the 2024-2025 academic session of various categories of filmmaking and purpose discovery courses. FTW, over the years, has been a formidable platform built by God for the advancement of his cause here on Earth. This year's edition will be offering basic, advanced, and professional diploma programs in faith-based filmmaking. Come and have a date with your maker, as participants do at the Powerful Encounter Clinics and Prayer Quakes. The workshop is also open to children of ages 10 and above. Hurry now and enroll for the first semester of this session, holding between April 6 and 14, 2024. Course fee at the entry level, which is for basic certificate, is 30,000 Naira only. Children's course fee is 15,000 Naira only. This covers for tuition, accommodation, and the course pack. Food is available for sale on campus at affordable price. Venue is LaSalle College, Haribabola, Ondo City, Ondo State, Nigeria. Students can come with laptops, cameras, and other filmmaking gadgets if available for group projects. For more inquiry, call 070-644-0150 and 081-6847-6985. The FTW, we are not a mistake in this cosmos.
You're welcome to another season of Encounter for the next 10 Sundays and the next 10 Fridays. Listen to the following prophetic instructions and be intentional about them. Number one, please do well to watch every part of every video. Do not forward any part. Every part needs to be viewed. Number two, each Friday that comes after the Sunday you are watching this video now will be a video dedicated to the issues discussed in the movie. The VG will take place between 12 a.m. and 1 a.m. Nigerian time, middle of the night. We advise you not to pray the prayers in the day. We advise you to join the VG live. We advise you not to sleep and then wake up and then join the VG. It's an instruction from God. You don't pray this kind of prayers in the day. You pray them in the night where you can begin to see effect right here and now. So please do not miss any VG online every Friday on this YouTube channel. Number three, each of the parts will begin with a 3 minutes worship section. Please, partake in the worship section. The worship section was an intentional instruction by the Spirit of God to open up the portal for your deliverance. Do not just keep the song and say it's getting too long. No. Partake in the worship section, sing all the songs, let your mind be lifted. You can pray in tongues as you sing while you go into the movie. This is not the normal movie you watch and say you are entertained. This is a deliverance clinic. And so please take these instructions to heart. Number four, do not forget the way of sacrifice. If you followed all the previous parts you've been watching, sacrifice against sacrifice is very key. And so listen to me. Part of the sacrifice is this. Subscribe to this channel, like this channel, and make sure you share this video. Make sure you do. Do you know why? If you are connected to a hotter and you are expecting to be delivered, you are expecting to be blessed, you are expecting for God to help you through this hotter, you must be connected to the hotter in the way you support, in terms of subscribing, liking, and sharing. Many of you have this attitude of downloading the video on your phone and sending it to people. We receive calls from them all over the world. They don't know us, they don't know our channel, they don't know we have other movies that we have produced. All they want to know is about the keeper, they don't know the source. Please, if you are going to recommend this film to people, let them know the source. Let them know where they can get it. Let them know where to get from. I'm not saying you should not download, but please try and stream online first, after which you can now download. But let people who you are telling about the movie know the ministry that produced it. Let them know the source where this movie is coming out. Through that, you are growing this platform to make other people to be blessed. So if you know you normally forget those things, do them right now. Share, like, and subscribe to this channel. Recommend this channel to people. Tell them how to get here. Finally, make sure you get a jotter and a pen to jot every prayer point and every revelation that come from this movie. For churches who want to use this movie as a premiere or want to join with the videos live in their own church videos, please let your protocol officer be strategically positioned so that people don't get to injure themselves by the manifestation of power that we emit from the sphere. At the same time, don't forget that sacrificial giving tied with understanding is a way to open up the presence of God to your cases. And so, as you are also praying and believing God, let there be a sacrificial giving, sacrificial sowing of seed with understanding. It's not a ritual, so that you can see that all these things work together prophetically for your good. You wonder how this brother saw this movie, how the brother may get to see this movie, all the inspiration behind this movie. Look at the power behind it. It didn't come by just sitting down and doing nothing. It came by sacrificial giving to understand the sacrificial giving to anointings, to men, to tap into revelation of God's mind. I pray that as you watch this movie, you shall be mightily blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much.
Calm down and tell me this thing.
What is the experience I had? I cannot be calm. You don't make me to I want to bust out. I want to bust.
See, save your greetings. I don't need them.
What is the problem? Your voice sounds weeping. What is the problem?
Don't ask me stupid question. I give you 24 hours to come and pick the idiot you dropped in my place.
That's too harsh. What is the matter?
Your God has done more wickedly to me. So he or you does not deserve any kind gesture from me. Come and pick that idiot now.
Warning against blasphemy. Whatever he cannot say to his father or to any authority here, he should not say that to God.
Sorry, I don't understand, sir. What have I done wrong?
How could you allow your wife to come into my house? My house.
I'm very, very sorry, sir. I'm really, really sorry. She didn't tell me she was caught. Oh my God. I'm sorry, Daddy. I'm sorry, sir.
Am I responsible for everything going on in your family? It is dangerous for her.
You will need to visit your dad again. And this time around, it's not going to be your wife, but you, sir.
Who?
You.
Me.
Daddy, man.
You must be joking. Me.
Oh, a season of ancestral wickedness and time of altars, the destiny of great families rests on the shoulders of Christ's redemptive power through a young priest. His name, Brojan.
About the merchandise you are about to buy.
What are you talking about? What merchandise?
That man you are trying to elope with is my husband. I cannot share it with anybody.
I don't do such. I'm not a husband snatcher. They must be mixed up somewhere.
You are very stupid. You are playing on my intelligence. I speak with excitement. You are one.
And what that meaning should be given to that dream? Is this not God's revelation to me? Ask him, who is Regina? And I just came because he said you're his pastor.
Calm down, sister. Take things easy. No revelation, no result. I mean, for me, I think these are answered prayers. Who is Regina?
What kind of life is this? I don't know anybody by the name Regina. I've not even met any lady named Regina.
See, at this point, you just have to tell the truth. Yes, there is nothing to be afraid of. You just have to open up.
I am telling the truth, and I lie not. I don't know anybody by the name Regina.
You see, Pastor, I came from a polygamous family, and I know what it means to live in a righteous family. My mom died in the midst of this heat, and I cannot gullibly walk myself into another situation again.
Calm down. Calm down, sister. Can I ask you a question?
Okay.
Do you love him?
Of course I do. But I cannot love with unrest and trouble.
I know she loves him. Cynthia, there is no problem.
Lisa, can I be telling
you? Of course, I will.
Thank you.
Bro, Jun, don't let her go. I think you gave me to beg her.
Beg her? Bro, you need to calm down. You need to take things easy. When it comes to the issues of marriage, you do not beg either party to marry each other. Any marriage, any relationship that the foundation is laid on begging will continually be sustained by begging. Why must we beg her to marry you? For what?
Because I'm innocent.
We should beg her because you are evil? Calm down. Brotul, God has begun on your case. Jude, let's go.
Are you not going to say anything?
What do you want me to say? Brotul, speaking without revelation is babbling without knowing. Just calm down. Let me go and seek. Then we'll come back to you.
But at least, give me some prayer points.
All right. You can pray that God should reveal the hidden secret to you. Like, let your Daniel dream appear. No?
Thank you.
Sir, you have to face your father.
I can't. No, I can't. I cannot go to the house. If I do, I don't know the outcome. No, I don't.
Of course, I know you can't. I mean, you can't go there with this, your current version. Because this, your current version, is already defeated. So you can't.
How do you mean, ma'am?
You see, anyone who is afraid or lives in fear is already defeated by default. His or her talk will be full of fear. And when fear dominates a man, oh, faith vanishes. And the Bible says, without faith, no man can please the Lord. Yes, it is impossible to please the Lord. So if you are living in fear, definitely it is not possible to please the Lord. That one is automatic.
And of a truth, I want to please the Lord.
Unfortunately, with this fear, you cannot please the Lord.
See, oh God. Madam, you don't understand. If John is here, we'll have explained better to you. No, it's not possible. You don't know him. You don't know my father. You don't know him.
Do you know your God? Is your father not a man? You see, the Lord has sent us as witnesses to this earth to defeat the works of the devil.
Thank you, ma'am. Don't mind him. It is only in this house and in the company that uses bold face. See, if your father is indeed responsible for what we are going through in this family, you don't have any choice than to face him.
You see, we will pray. We will prepare. And we shall seek the face of God. But you have to face him. You have to face him. If you don't bind a strong man, you cannot plunder the goods.
Kai, you don't understand. No, I'm sure you don't understand. You don't know Baba Weye. He is merciless and diabolic.
This is what will happen. We will find time to pray together. And I pray that the Lord will reveal the hidden secret to us.
Amen. Thank you very much, ma'am. See, whatever it will take, I am ready. Because their wives are the ones facing the brunt. They are doing fine. They are okay.
Hey.
Thank you.
Hey.
Just calm down, my sister. Eh? It is well with you, my sister. Please, just calm down. All will be well.
About where are you?
I came to check my marriage document with Tolu to check if he's still binding.
When was this marriage?
Since the beginning, and their family succubus. So, it is not just to one, but to all male children in their family.
The family name?
Tolu Lope Gbade Geshi.
It is still pounding, still intact.
Their warning, I will kill him. Anytime he tries getting engaged, I have stopped him. He is at it again. Warning, a marriage has been conducted here. No other marriage must be.
Succubus, don't worry. I will get in contact with the keeper of the altar. You can go.
Keeper of the sacrifice. Another urgent information?
I hate nonsense. I have legal binding. Oh, I don't waste my life keeping legal documents in vain.
Calm down. Please, calm down. keeper of the sacrifice. What is it this time?
One of the succubus came to me and she told me she was threatened. She's boiling. She came to confirm their documents. And of course, it is still intact.
Whose succubus are you talking about?
Tolu's succubus.
There is no cause for alarm. It is the sexual demon of their father's house. In fact, two of her elder sisters are still looking for men to marry them.
Oh! There is judgment! There is punishment! This is the highest caliber of demon. Let them know.
Have you ever seen anyone who defeats the menace of spirit husband and spirit wife? Even after several supposed deliverance, Harper.
They better have this understanding and stick to their relationship because it is binding to death.
Is that? I don't think I understand all this. No, I don't.
Virgil,
I even saw the keeper of the sacrifice.
Virgil, what is it?
I just saw something so disturbing that I don't even have understanding at all.
The Lord will give you revelation, will give you understanding, Virgil. See.
Succubus.
Having John and his family to come and live here in this house with us has been a tremendous blessing. It's been a great blessing to us. And you've always said that. I must give that to you.
They brought light. If not, we would still be battling with all these family altars for no reason.
The throne of grace. The throne of grace. You know, that passage there. Hebrews 4:16 has become my favorite verse on the Bible.
I am happy it was I who meant that I gave you that verse.
Yes, yes. And I'm grateful to God for who you are.
Thank God. And I have to return to my people. We have a whole lot to do under God.
No problem. You can go anytime.
So you know you're not stopping me. So you will not mess with me again.
The absence of man is the presence of the Holy Spirit. I need to shut down this realm and go back to the other realm. I desire another encounter.
Kai, truly you visited the throne of grace. Mm-hmm. I can see the grace with you. You see, one of the major pieces of evidence you will find in the life who has visited the throne of grace is the sincere and strong hunger for God.
Mm-hmm. All right. Every single day, I desire to know more. I want to experience deeper. There's this hunger, this yearning, this thirst to know more.
Your dream looks somehow. I really don't understand what it means.
You see, when I was growing up, I think I've had people talking about spirit husband, spirit wife, you know, things like that.
Oh, really? That spirit husband, spirit wife, can you tell us more about it? Like, is it that the marriage is conducted in the spiritual realm or what?
Like I said, I don't really know much about this, but I've had people talking about the stuff. That's just...
Then I think we have to pray and seek the face of God so that He can explain these things to us, for us to know more about it, the rules of engaging them. Because That dream was awful.
Sincerely, we need to. Because this thing that I said is happening, it's not just happening to Brotolo. Mm. It's happening to all his other sisters that are supposed to be married at matured age, but they are not yet married.
The devil is wicked.
Honestly.
In fact, using the word wicked is an understatement.
A lot of
demonic mysteries, spiritual mysteries that many Christians don't know about.
Mm. Ah,
my people perish for lack of understanding.
I thank God for using us in a time like this. Hallelujah. And please, I want you to, in fact, I want us to remember your boss in our prayers. Mm. I really need God's revelation concerning their case.
Revelation.
Have you forgotten? No revelation, no results. Fakati?
Tolu Lope. Tolu? What is wrong? I really don't get you on phone. Hey, what were you saying about Cynthia?
Cynthia is gone.
Gone? What? What killed her? How did it happen?
She did not die.
Uh-uh.
I lost her. We broke up. She said she had a dream to have another woman in my life.
Another woman? Oh, Jesus. Jesus, what is all this that are happening to us? Fabi and I have been praying. And we've been fasting over this issue that this your current relationship should lead to marriage. So that it will be a template and hope of our own miracle. Now this again.
Where is Sister Febe?
Febe has gone to the mountain to pray. See, tomorrow will be the seventh day of our marathon prayer. Over this issue. And see what's happening now. I'm fed up.
For how long? I thought this would be a success. This has been the longest relationship I've ever had.
Tolulope, all will be well. Very soon, it's going to be alright.
Are you really sure about this?
I am sure. Because every problem in life has its own expiry date. Although it's not going to be easy. But all is well. Trust me, okay?
What about Engineer Korede? Are you guys getting along?
Engineer Korede? He stopped calling me. In fact, if I send him text messages, he doesn't reply. In fact, I took my time to see him in his office.
Who be that? Are they come? Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon.
And what do you want?
Actually, I'm here to see Engineer Akorede.
Okay. So you don't tell her before you come?
Oh, no, not really.
So this is your name?
Tell him Hannah.
Hannah, okay.
Yes.
You think I'll be back?
Okay, but I'm not a visitor yet. I've been here before.
You know if you enter. You know if you enter inside.
Like, are you for
you know if you enter. Yes.
Okay. What is that?
Okay, one person they ask for you forget.
From where? What's the name?
She said her name is Anna.
Average height, fair complexion.
Yes, sir.
See, I don't want to see her. Okay? Yes, tell her I'm not around.
Okay, sir.
Kofi, tell her I have gone out and do not allow her into the premises anymore.
Okay, sir.
Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
You can go.
Thank you, sir.
What nonsense. Called and did not pick up. Message, no reply. Don't you get the message? What else do I have to do? It seems I have to block you. Okay, that way you will get it finally. In your sense.
Welcome back. Yeah. Can I come in now?
No. I'll go there.
What?
In the end, you'll come out.
Wow. So you mean he wasn't around?
Gonna be around.
But how come you went inside to check if he's in his office or not?
if you knew that it was not allowed. And as a matter of fact, is that not his car being parked there?
Madam, I beg you best, on my fault. I got no idea, he don't come out. The car where you see there, can I company get him on? Company car, no guess.
All right, you know what? I don't mind waiting for him at the reception.
Madam, you know you enter. You go call him for phone. So if you call him for phone, or maybe come back later. So for now, you know if you come with someone for reception, yeah?
All right, it's okay. I'm calling.
Thank you. Madam.
Yes.
I don't like you. I don't like you again.
Wait, just wait. Like, did he tell you that?
She, I want to lie me. I see a guy no day dressed at the game.
You mean Akorede is inside?
No talk saying I'm tell you. No talk saying I'm tell you. Nah, if I just do you.
Yeah, I understand.
Bye, you can go.
Alright.
Yeah, go.
Thank you.
You won't sleep here?
Actually, I'll go. I'll
go. Come out now.
It looks so new to me. Marriage in the spiritual realm.
This devil is a shit. A very big one at it. Or isn't it obvious that every institution the Lord has formed, every system that the Lord has made, is also being copied by him?
What is this succubus of a thing? What does it really mean?
Succubus is a spiritual wife. Like, more like a female demon, according to understanding.
Does that mean that anyone who is married in the spirit or spiritually married or married to this succubus of a thing, whatever, doesn't mean that it will be difficult for them, that is, even if it is possible at all, for them to be physically married?
It's a serious issue. But what I need to know actually is, how do people come in contact with this spirit husband or spirit wife? Is it voluntary? Is it forceful?
Exactly.
What will it be?
Or are there lifestyles that make one, that put one in bondage?
Or is it even the issues of altars? What are the rules of engagement when it comes to spiritual spouses?
Because there are so many people who are matured for marriage, both gender, male and female, who are out there but could not get a spouse successfully. And some ladies are there. That the kind of men that see them, they are the married men or of serious men. And eventually, out of frustration and pressure, they give in and get married to them. They get settled with these men at the end of the day.
See, it is succubus that is affecting Tolu.
Succubus.
But how does his fiancé, Cynthia, how does she see a dream of Tolu being engaged in a dream?
Why? Do you understand? The succubus will continue to distract this lady. The succubus can be the one, you know, polluting the dream life of this lady and making the lady to understand that she is engaged to the man. And through that, the man, or let me say, through that, the woman will no longer want to go on with the man. It's all succubus.
How do we get the spiritual understanding to all of this?
That's all assignment. We need to sit down, to seek and pray, to know the secrets behind these spiritual spouses, so that we can be of help to a generation out there.
Get out, you good-for-nothing girl! Stupid girl!
Who is this again?
That must be the other neighbor Mom Collins told us about.
In this house again? Please, let's focus. Succubus.
Idiot! Eh? Solo of Egbon Oni. Solo of Egbon.
Mommy, I'm 33 already. Aren't you ashamed? Are you not worried?
Worried about what? Beleo, you are 33.
I mean, I'm married. Or in their husband's house, starting their own family, even with kids.
People of your age, are they not dead? Oh, shape PRA, we are one. So because your mates are married, they have kids, so pillow comic.
Mom, I'm your only daughter. I need to settle down.
Stop deceiving yourself, fool. You cannot marry another man, I've told you. You cannot. You are married.
How do you expect?
What do you call that, Kenry? Whoa, 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 get out and leave my house. Leave my house now.
I should leave you.
Leave my house.
Leave! I should leave
there. Go!
No problem, I'll leave.
Wami, tell me what when we come here, you will meet it here. Silly girl!
What am I to do? I am 33 years old. All my mates are married. There is no spouse I bring to her that she will approve. Instead, she will embarrass me in front of them and chase them away.
Ura, all these things that you are saying, I'm aware of it now. We've been living in this compound together, so I'm aware of it. But don't worry, God is in control.
She keeps telling me that I'm married to one man that comes to me at night, violating me.
One man? Is he your friend? I mean, how does he come to you?
He's more of a spirit.
I'm sorry, I don't really understand. Spirit, he comes, okay, is he a human being that comes like a spirit? I mean, he comes spiritually and physically. I don't understand.
Sometimes he comes physically and at times he don't.
This type, I don't understand it because I don't think I've even heard of it before. This is my first time of hearing that a spirit sleeps with a human being and he comes physically and spiritually. And your mother said you are married to him. This one has passed me. You know what? Have you noticed this, our new neighbor? These young boys like this. They are young, but they are hot. And they have God inside of them. So I will recommend that you go and meet them. I recommend that you go speak to them. Tell them this problem. I'm sure there'll be a solution.
I don't mind. Just help me. Just help me.
Don't worry. I will introduce them to you. They are very powerful. They have God at the eye level.
Just help me. I don't mind. Help me.
Well, then, you trespass by coming to my house. You must die. I need blood. Broken, I need blood. I need blood.
Jesus. 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 I reject it in Jesus' name. I reject it. My blood is preserved in the name of Jesus. Dear. Dear.
Mm-hmm. What is it? What is the problem?
What have I done to your family? Especially your father that he wants to kill me. He wants to use my blood to renew his sacrifice like he did your mother.
What exactly is wrong with you? Roke, what is your problem? Why are you putting your mouth in sensitive issues like this? What if I didn't tell you? What's your problem, no? Eh?
What is more important than my life? Your father wants to kill me, Abi. He will not succeed in Jesus' name. I saw him. He carried a calabash in front of a mirror. He will not succeed. God scattered their plan in the name of Jesus. Baba. Anyone that wants to kill me, that wants to use me to renew his sacrifice, Lord, scatter their plan in the name of Jesus. Scatter their plan in the name of Jesus. They will not succeed. I will not die. I will not die. No, I will not die in the name of Jesus.
Is there anything that you need to tell us that you have not told us? Maybe the things you told Mother Collins? That you still need to tell us that we have not heard about the situation?
Except that she always told me that I am married to a priest from birth.
A priest? Which priest? I mean, which priest marries a child from birth?
You don't know. Mm-hmm. There are lots of evil priests out there. A whole lot of them.
There is nothing that we can do of ourselves. Mm-hmm. There's nothing we can do of our own. You see, our relevance is only in the revelation that we carry. One of the major keys of relevance in what you do is having revelation about that thing that you do. Mm. That is it. And so, most of the works lies with you.
How, sir?
We need to pray. We need to engage ourselves in, you know, high deliverance prayers. Mm. We also need to disengage from this spiritual house that is affecting your marital house.
See, this man, is so handsome. Like, so handsome.
You mean the spirits that usually come to fight you all the time?
No, he doesn't fight with me. He's very gentle and even patient. In fact, he usually come to beg me not to leave him and cheat on him. And most time, I usually feel for him.
What are you saying, Wura? Huh? What are you saying?
We have many cases in our hands like that. You see, there is no amount of prayers and deliverance we can do that deliverance can come to her.
Ah,
yeah, because it's obvious that she is not ready to leave a spiritual spouse. She only wants to, you know, get married out of the shame of not being physically married. It's obvious.
Please, wait, Wura. Is it true that you don't want to disengage from this man? Or this spirit, or whatever you call it?
He is nice, very gentle, and patient with me. In fact, I don't want to hurt him.
Okay, Ma. Hey, Jude, let's go. Mommy Collins, Collins return. Help us to greet him. You find time to sing very well. A general love.
Please do go, sir. I don't miss.
Please subscribe.
I don't know the kind of dream Cynthia is having. I don't know who is the one preventing me from getting married. What I know is a demonic spirit.
I renounce every spirit hindering my marital testimony in Jesus' name. I come against every woman or lady blackmailing my God ordained spouse in the name of Jesus, Lord. I renounce. Jesus! I renounce. I renounce. I renounce. I come against. 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 In the name of Jesus, every lady hindering my God ordained spouse, I renounce. In the name of Jesus.
I am Succubus. I'm your family wife. How dare you leave and marry another woman?
I don't know you. Neither do I remember marrying you.
You don't need to know me before marrying me. I have every right to be your wife. And I assure no other woman in your life.
So you are the one that told Cynthia my fiance? You are the one!
Don't you ever mention her as your fiance.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I don't know you. Leave me alone. Kill me.
Fool. Be fool.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I don't know you. Leave me alone. Jesus.
Fool. Be fool. You are my husband. We are married. And soon, we start having children together.
Jesus! Jesus! How come? Marry spiritually. Is this how my big aunt is living together? I also married spiritually. And he keep stopping the physical marriage. He? Ha! Ha! How come? How come they beat me spiritually? And I'm seeing it physically? Ha! Ha!
Oh.
I'm done.
I intentionally decided that we do our talk here so that at least it will give me the privilege to see Brotolu's elder sisters.
Thank you, my dear brother. Tolu have told us many things about you, and we are glad to meet you. I don't know the solution you want to provide, but let us tell you some things we have done and steps we have taken. We have prayed and fasted all manner of fast. Awe fufu, awe biribiri, eleso, kosele tagbato. In fact, we have worshipped God. We have gone to so many mountains and valleys. Orioke pele, orioke pao, orioke baba biye, orioke baba lede, kosele tagye. See, you see this, our faces that you are seeing, and this is our head. We have washed it with anointing oil and homie ye. At the worship. That is not all. You did not remind him of different seminars we have attended. We were told to use makeup, make ourselves approachable, and dash ourselves out for men to see. Would you want to read? That's this shaking.
I really, really feel for you, Max.
Thank you.
Everything you have said, it's good, but not all can ascertain deliverance. You see, the kind of spirit that you are battling with does not know powder, does not know Mary Kay, does not know anointing oil. And sometimes, even if you don't fast rightly, it may not even affect them at all. There are rules of engagement that we need utmost revelation to know about these things.
Yes, Bro John. I am fully persuaded that I have a spirit wife. Because I don't know when spirits start to marry humans.
That is the work of the devil. The devil hates godly married. He doesn't want anybody to marry at all.
Yes, sir.
He doesn't want it.
And what you are currently working on is even to know the cause. How do one get spirit spouse? And how do one engage it?
Do you all believe God?
Yes,
sir. You believe in Jesus?
Yes, sir.
I know many whole and sundry prophets and pastors have said diverse things to you. They have given you several solutions in the name of Jesus, and it looks like this thing keeps recurring. Irresponsible men comes, the woman comes and go, the responsible ones come. But do you believe in Jesus?
Yes.
Do you believe that Jesus was made manifest so that he might destroy the works of the devil? Then, let's all rise and pray.
You see, the kind of prayers you want to pray are not normal prayers. They are warfare prayers. You cannot pray this kind of prayer with all your faith and all your strength and not see results. The result might be some dreams. Let's shout this loud and clear. Every soul tie,
every soul tie
connecting me to spirit husband or wife,
connecting me to spirit husband or wife.
Every soul tie,
every soul tie
connecting me to spirit husband or wife,
connecting me to spirit husband.
I break. Begin to pray. Break. Every soul tie connecting me to spirit wife, I break in the name of Jesus Christ. Every soul tie connecting me to spirit wife, I break in the name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Every power. Pretending to be my husband or wife.
Pretending to be my husband.
In the dream. You know, we have the impersonator spirits. They come to impersonate.
Every power,
every power,
every demon,
every demon,
every spirit, pretending to be my husband or wife,
pretending to be my husband
in the dream,
in the dream,
die, praise Jesus' name. Every spirit, every spirit, pretending to be my wife in the dream, die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Die in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. The truth is, there are many singles with spiritual spouses and they don't know. These spiritual spouses will be so unconscious, waiting for them when they get to the junction of marriage.
But how do one encounter this wicked demon?
Exactly. Exactly what we are going to be discussing next. It is then people will know if they are at a risk of spiritual spouses or not.
What have you come to do?
I don't even know what I came to do. But I know God sent me here. Because it's obvious I have an assignment in this realm.
What assignment?
Sister Anna. Sister Dorcas. What are you doing here? You are not supposed to be seen here.
How dare you? How dare you tell my wife that they should not be with their one and only husband?
My wife is here. Are they married to you?
You must be blind. Can't you see the wedding rings in their hands?
But how did they get married to you? Are they even aware at all? Because you see these ones, they are not happy marrying you.
Take a look at their faces. Do you see any sign of sadness in it? Come on, young boy. I will advise you return back to where you came from.
I will go. But I want you to answer this question. How did they get married to you? Who conducted the wedding?
I am the husband of every female child in this family. Their forefathers engaged in a whole lot of sexual perversion and molestation. And you know what? That got us into this family. And anyway, you see, incubus will marry all their female child.
Hope you know they are not married in the physical realm. See, look at their beautiful faces. Men run away from them. They don't get engaged.
Who told you they are beautiful? We kept their beauty right here. Take a look at what they really look like.
What? Who are these? Wow!
Those are your beautiful sisters. And this is what the suitor sees in them whenever they make their interest known. We have kept their real beauty here.
But wait, will these ones ever be married again?
Never.
Ah, they can never be married again.
Don't you see the rings in their hands? Or do you want to show you the wedding seals?
Wait. Enough of all this nonsense. Go back to where you came from. This is no go area for you.
Don't believe anything they told you. Even if they wear what is more than rings, we have a solution for legal access.
How do you know? Did you see anything?
Not really. I just have an understanding for incubus and succubus.
Who? Oh, you know incubus?
Well, John, what's incubus?
Incubus is a sexual male demon that puts women in bondage of spiritual marriage, making it difficult for them to get married or to even have conception.
I have some revelations too.
Later, we'll gather all we have together and possibly distribute herself to, you know, prospective and responsive persons. Later, when mom come back from the VG at the boss place.
Wait,
Who is there? Please come in.
Peace be unto this house. Good afternoon, ma.
Good afternoon, ma. Good afternoon, ma. Please, yes, please have your seat.
Thank you. Thank you, ma. God bless you, ma. We are the new neighbors staying
downstairs. Oh, Mommy Collins mentioned it to us when we came back from the village.
Okay.
And honestly, I tried so much to come and see you.
Okay.
I'm a very busy person.
Oh, you're welcome. Understand. Thank you, ma.
You're welcome.
Well done, ma. Thank you, ma.
Yes, ma. So how is the family?
Ah, we thank God. Family is good. We are very fine, ma. Thank you, ma. Thank you for accommodating us.
You're welcome, ma.
Shegoni, ma. I've actually come to greet you and then to, you know, ask you some questions and...
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Ah, thank you. Thank you, ma. You see, I heard it from Mommy Collins. And she said, I think your daughter and her friend, that your daughter offended you and it hurt you so bad, you didn't like it. So I felt I should come and apologize on her behalf. Emma Bino, Cherry and Omoe, you see the children of nowadays.
Yeah? Offend me?
Yes.
No. My daughter did not offend me.
Ah.
Where did you get that from?
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. So why is she now not
Madam, please go straight to the point.
Okay. Thank you. So why is she not married? I was told that you don't want her to get married. And you've been rejecting all her suitors.
Yes.
But why?
Because she's married.
Oh, really? Or
is it possible for somebody that is married to marry another
person? I know, that's a bad thing.
Uh-huh.
No, I didn't know she's married. So, Bura is married.
Yes.
Then why is she running after other men? Ah, I need to talk to that Bura. I need to cancel her. And I need to see her husband too.
You cannot see her husband.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. It is only Bura that can see her husband.
Is he a spirit that nobody can see?
Madam, Chelsea. Please, enough of all those questions. You may leave my house now.
Ah, I'm happy.
Eshe.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you for accommodating.
Thank you. Eshe.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Eshe, ma. My regards to you. God bless you.
Mm-hmm.
Eshe, go. Yes, ma. Good job, ma.
Wala busi, baby.
That's the exact situation. You see, we have different categories of these spiritual spouses. We have the physical one that people can actually see them physically.
Yeah, just like this one. It's obvious she's seeing him. It's obvious.
We also have the conscious and the unconscious one. You see, the enemy hides them from many singles so that they will not know. Because the enemy knows that if they know, they will fight back.
To me, I think this is the most dangerous category. Because it is what you know that you will fight.
Exactly.
We have the spiritual prostitute. We have the family spirit spouses. We have the hermaphrodite spirits. This one possesses both the male and the female sexual organ. Dimensions of the dark world.
There are so many issues with these demons. Fighting from the spiritual realm and causing confusion in the physical realm.
Yes, so much.
Mom, you see, you have to talk to Wura, possibly in Mrs. Chuk's flat.
Okay.
While, you know, Jude will go and talk to Tolu, the mental manager.
Okay.
Then Philip and I will talk to their sisters who are also single looking for marital testimony.
That's good. That's a very good arrangement.
And you see, it's just for understanding. Because my people perish for lack of understanding. When they have understanding of what is happening around them, then they'll be able to engage properly.
That is it, you're right. By the way, your boss asked of you. I want you to find time to go and see him and encourage him, please. We have started a 3-day vigil already.
I do hope that God will help me. I will find time to go and see him. Possibly Jude and I or Philip and I can go and check on him. God will help us all.
Amen. No problem.
More of the truth, my dear. I think I am ready to face my father. I can challenge him now.
Of course, you have to face him, even if he's the devil.
I'm even prepared to the point that if no one will go with me, I'm ready to go all out. Okay? Even if you will kill me, I'm ready to die, trying to make change through faith.
You cannot die. He cannot even kill you. You cannot die but live and declare the goodness of God. The door is not locked. Please come in.
Oh, God's visitor in April. It's so good to see you. You're welcome, sir. Philip, how are you?
It's been a while. How are you?
We thank God. You know, it's been challenges here and there. But we thank God because we know that in no time everything will be all right.
Let's go. Let's go.
Philip, you are gradually resembling Bro John. Bro John's disciple.
Not only disciple, Bro John's everything.
That's good.
Actually, I didn't really plan to come today. But I came because the Holy Spirit sent me to you and your family, especially you, sir.
Okay.
That's awesome. Please go ahead,
share. You see, the Holy Spirit spoke to me in Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 6. And it says, be strong and of a good courage. Fear not, nor be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he it is that doth go with thee. He will not fail thee, nor forsake thee.
Permit me to add this, brethren, in Isaiah 41:18. And it says, for I, the Lord God, will hold thy right hand, saying, fear not, for I will help thee.
Men of God, indeed. In fact, God sent you to us because there's an issue we've been facing in this family.
It's just what we're just discussing.
You need not be afraid of them. Because if you are afraid of them, their faith is strengthened to defeat you. But like the righteous, if you are as bold as lions, your boldness will kick out their faith and then fear will come to them.
Wow! That is deep, Bro John. Can you imagine? I must sincerely tell you, since the vigil and prayer session started, my faith has gone up high. And I must use this opportunity to say thank you to you and your family.
Thank you.
You've been there for us. God bless you, really good.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Show me a faithless and a fearful Christian, then I will show you a prayerless Christian.
Exactly. You see, there are times we have fears and burdens, but when you exactly and directly go to God, you will see the morale and faith that will come, even when the challenges tear at you.
Yeah, when the challenges tear at you, you have a morale that comes up.
Your presence has always been a blessing to us. Thank you.
We thank God. And you see, sir, there's nothing to be afraid of. Faith is an important tool to winning any battle in life, not just prayer. When you pray without faith, it's like having a gun without a bullet.
Did you get that? Gun without a bullet. Bro John, thank you. Thank you so much. God bless you. You're good for us. If you have the opportunity once in a while, just show up at the company. Okay? Even if it's just to say hi.
God is helping us.
Amen. Can we get them something to drink?
Please subscribe.
I heard footsteps. Are you okay? Why this unhappy face?
Come,
let's talk.
Mom.
Come here.
I think God is selfish. He's been so sentimental about the people he loves.
Why would you say that? Wait, come and sit first. Sit here. Collins, why would you say that God is selfish or sentimental?
There are some people he has chosen to use because he loves them. And he has invested a lot of power on them without even doing anything. Yet some fast, pray, study, and we have no power of grace at all.
Collins, why would you say that?
I know what I'm saying. Look at David. David, you called him a man after his heart. The same David. Mm-hmm. And the same pure Jesus Christ, also came out from the family line. Look at Samson. He died with his enemies.
Collins, are you studying the Bible to be able to pick out God's errors or mistakes?
Mom, no. No. Look at Bro John. Look at Philip and Jude. God has been using them. But they are only lucky, Mom. They are only lucky because God has been silent on me. I don't even know. Maybe I'm growing, Mom. I don't know.
Collins, don't say that. Listen. Grace doesn't just jump on people. Nothing does drop. Even this grace attracts only those who align themselves with the systems of God.
Mom, there's nothing special that I think they do. Nothing. There's nothing special. Believe me, God just loves some people than others. He loves some people than others. But I'm not saying some people. I'm just trying to say this, to fight against God. But I just want to grow like Bro John. I want God to use me too.
God will use you. The first thing you're getting right is that there's the hunger for it. So since there's the hunger, don't worry. Other things will align. You know what I'll do? I will speak to Bro John. I will ask him to help you and possibly mentor you.
Please do.
I will.
I don't even know. Maybe there's any method they are using to pray that I did not know. Mom, I'm fed up.
Don't be fed up. You will go. Colin, you will go.
There's no way you want to demonstrate God's kingdom without power.
Mm.
Power is needed to be able to take over kingdoms, to pull down strongholds of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to pray. My Lord Jesus.
My Lord Jesus.
Give me the spirit of power.
Give me the spirit of power.
To be able to demonstrate your kingdom.
To demonstrate the kingdom.
Everywhere I go.
Pardon, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me with power.
Let the power of fire, strength of power, to demonstrate the dimension of your kingdom. Anywhere, they will know your kingdom, the kingdom of the Father, in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
According to Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 29, it says, "Is his word not like fire, or like a hammer that breaks rock into pieces?" Let's tell it to God. Lord, make your word in my mouth like fire, and let it be a hammer that breaks rock into pieces. Pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your word in my mouth be like fire. Every satanic hole that has introduced my life to fear, that has introduced me to by the blood of Jesus. I can't do it by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
We are still praying. Jesus. You will say, you strong God of fear.
You strong God of fear.
Release me now by fire.
Release me now by fire.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Release me now by fire.
Richard,
I'm not threatening you, Dad.
Then who is threatening me?
I don't know.
But I am being threatened. Where is the fear I planted?
How does that supposed to be my problem? Maybe somebody came and blocked it out. I don't know.
Then who must that be?
I don't know.
Then what must I do?
I don't know.
What exactly do you know?
Nothing! I know nothing!
Then it means there is nothing you can ever do that can threaten me.
I can't say, sir.
Then you remain silent for the rest of your life or I silence you.
No, you can't. No. No. I'll not silence Jesus too.
Honey? Hmm? What happened? Huh?
I saw my dad.
Okay.
He said I was threatening him.
Tell me more.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ah, thank you.
That is a very good dream and revelation.
Hmm.
The truth is that your father has attacked you all with the spirit of fear. For all of you to just be afraid of him is not normal. It's not natural.
Not at all. I can tell, ma. It is so natural. You can imagine, even at this age, we're still so afraid of him.
He's actually tormenting you with the spirit of fear. Because he knows if the fear is not there, all of you will rise up to fight him for whatever predicament he has placed on you.
So, ma, what is happening now, ma?
The spirit of fear that he planted in him has vanished from you. And it has returned to the sender, back to sender.
Thank
it has returned
Jesus.
To the sender. And as we speak now, the spirit of fear is tormenting him. Yes. And he's just afraid now as you speak. For whatever reason, he can't even figure out.
That is very true. I refuse to be locked down by fear. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. You see, fear is a torment. And it is one of the ways that the devil uses to incapacitate believers. But when fear disappears, faith and confidence will come.
That is true. See, I can't wait to face my father.
Wow.
I have the boldness now. I can't wait to face him after several years.
Yes, you will. You will. You need to face him. After this prayer, you will face him. And for now, I will leave you with God. Please take note of everything we have discussed.
Yes.
Thank you, Ma. Thank you so much.
Thank God.
Thank you, Ma.
Thank God.
Hello? Have you seen the picture I sent to you? I don't want mistake. Get him. Kidnapping. Kill him. I don't need his body. But put his blood in a calabash and bring it. I will also need videos of his last moment fighting for life. You know, it will be a good video to watch. Fast one, guys.
If you don't know how these sexual demons got into your life, then you will not know what to engage to get rid of them.
I don't think I should fall into any of these categories because I'm a virgin and I've never had a girlfriend. What connects sexual immorality with any?
What is it, sir? Is there any problem?
Incubus, do not disturb yourself. You didn't beg to marry them. Their forefathers paid allegiance that attracted you into their lineage.
My husband of 35 years is asking for divorce and I'm being threatened.
And what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do about that? What?
Don't I have a wedding certificate here with you?
Tell me, who dare stop the spirit of revelation?